Hi everyone. My name is Callie, aka Callie's Jams, and today we are going to be doing another album reaction video. Today we are going to be reacting to Olivia Rodrigo's new album, Guts. This just came out last week, so by the time that this video is uploaded, I would say it's about a week old or maybe a week and a half. And I'm gonna be very honest here, I'm not the biggest Olivia Rodrigo fan. I am not really looking forward to this album reaction video, but I kind of want to make an album reaction video where it's trendy, but it's not necessarily something that I like once in a while, because I feel like it just kind of adds more to the palette of what we've been reacting to so far. So Olivia Rodrigo is sadly one of those artists that I just don't favor that much. Without further ado, we're gonna listen to Guts together, and we're gonna listen to that shortly. But before I begin, I just wanna say one thing to all of you that have been so kind and supportive throughout this last week or so. I sincerely appreciate it. For those of you that do not know, I was in surgery. I had appendicitis and a ruptured ovarian cyst, so that was scary, but I'm feeling somewhat normal now. I feel a lot more energetic than I used to, and I'm at home and getting back to these projects that I love. So thank you all so much for being so patient and so supportive. It really means a lot to me. Without further ado, let's get into this album reaction. I have my headphones on. I'm ready to listen to Guts. Be prepared for some critique more than enjoyment, or maybe something will change and I actually like this record, but we'll see. I have a feeling that this is just not gonna be a great album, but we'll see. I am light as a feather and as stiff as a board. I pay attention to things that most people ignore. And I'm alright with the movies that make jokes about senseless cruelty, that's for sure. This isn't actually that bad. Hold on. I need to pause this. Those first 60 seconds were like really pretty. I love acoustic stuff, so that was like, mwah, that was like really good. And then it got to punky, and then I was like, but keep listening to it. It's all good. You can't resist. I'm a perfect American. I am light as a feather. I'm as fresh as the air. Coca-Cola bottles that I only used to grow my hair. Got class and integrity. Track one so far is, I sound like a hypocrite, but it's actually pretty good. Like, I would listen to this. Yeah, I kind of like it. I kind of like it. It's just not good, guys. I'm sorry. It's not. It's really like annoying. It's not catchy. It's just like, it's so, how do I put this? You need to have a song with class. And you need to have like a formula for it. This one is just literally ranting about the fact that you're running back to your ex, which is something that you should never flex about. It's weird, okay? And if you're gonna write a song about it, make it deep. Make it be like, why do you wanna see this person? When really she's just like, I just wanna go back to him because why not? Oh my God, it's like, are you just trying to lose friends? Are you trying to start a shit show? Like, whatever, it's fine. Now I've heard this song before, but not the entire thing. So we'll see how I feel about this.
Hate to give the satisfaction asking how you're doing now. How's the castle built of people you pretend to care about? Just what you wanted. Look at you, cool guy, got it. I see the parties and diamonds sometimes when I close my eyes. 6 months of torture you sold to some forbidden paradise. I loved you truly. You gotta laugh at the stupidity.
Bad Idea Right is just a bad song. It's just a bad song. Whereas Vampire, I don't like the instruments that much, but the lyrics are like really good. I don't really have much else to say. It's just, it's 50-50. It's 50-50. See, Olivia Rodrigo with acoustics, it matches perfectly. Like, she should do like a Shawn Mendes album where he did his first album and it was all just acoustic. Like, that would be perfect. Whoa. That minor harmony was like, that took me by surprise. That was, ooh, so far so good, so far so good. Great songwriting. Great formula. Good song. Good song. I don't know how to feel about this one. And it's like a carbon copy of every indie song ever. Yeah, this is, I don't know if I can listen to this. It's, I'm gonna be real with you guys, it's terrible. I don't like it. It sounds like track two, as I've said, and I didn't say this in the beginning, but one of the reasons why I'm not the biggest Olivia Rodrigo fan is because I feel like she just whines. Like, she whines a lot about her life. Like, she always complains about, like, what she goes through, and it's kind of annoying. I don't know, I'm not a fan.
Wanted so I got it, did it so it's done. Another thing I ruined, I used to do for fun. Another piece of plastic, I could just throw away. Another conversation with nothing good to say. I thought it so I said it, took it cause I can. Another day pretending. Older than I am, another perfect moment that doesn't feel like mine. Another thing I forced to be a sign.
It's not original. It's not. It just sounds like a copy-pasted song off of one artist, another song. It doesn't have a good, like, original storyline. Now, I could be a hypocrite because some of the artists that I really like, they're not original either, but it just, this is the same old story that I've been hearing with music for years. It's like, oh, I'm playing the victim and I'm, you know, running away from like my friends because I don't feel so included and I don't feel safe, but yet I've been doing all these things for myself, so I don't get it. It's like, we've heard this before. Whatever.
master manipulator. God, you're so good at what you do. Come for me like a savior. And I'd put myself through hell for you. Hear all the rumors lately that you always deny.
No love is never lost. Sorry, I don't really know what to say with this one. I'm trying to, like, figure out if I like it or not.
They got me thinking 2 + 2 = 5 and I'm...
See, do you see why I think she whines when she writes music? Like, you can only pull that theme for so long and people can enjoy it to a degree. But to the people that are into that and that's all they like, that's cool. Logical is it's a pretty song, like, for the ears, but lyrically speaking, I don't like it. I think it's unoriginal. It's the same old whiny, oh my god, I'm so sad, and like, da, da, da. It's just, do something else. This is a side eye. I'm sorry. Like, this is what I've been noticing in Guts so far. It's, let me get back with my ex because I feel like it. Oh wait, shit, he's a piece of shit, so I'm really sad and depressed. Oh, but I'm the victim and I'm like super, super sad. And now I wanna get him back and make him jealous. It's like, sis, formula speaking and storyline speaking, this is not looking good for you, babes. Like, do you think I need to explain further why I don't like her? this isn't a good record, guys. I'm sorry. Like, I'm kind of like, okay, like, this isn't bad. See, if Olivia Rodrigo did songs like this, where it was more about like self-growth and taking care of herself or admitting other problems besides heartbreak, yeah, maybe this would be a good album.
Whoa. gonna stop being great for my age. Just start being good. When will it stop being cool? Be quietly misunderstood.
Wait, this is deep though. Hold on. Interessante. Okay, so we're finally done with Guts. If I were to rate this album out of 10, I would say a 4. I'm gonna be honest here. Storyline speaking, it was the same old, like, I'm whining because a boy broke my heart kind of thing. And it made me upset because I know that artists can do better than that. And Olivia Rodrigo is one of those examples. All critique aside, she's extremely talented. She can sing very well. Her voice is absolutely gorgeous. And she just flows really well with good, like, ballads and stuff like that. But the problem is that she just uses it to the wrong genre and she uses it to the wrong message. I feel like if she would have made Guts more about herself and more like, let me improve myself, I would have liked this album a lot more. And I thought that's what she was going to bring to the table, honestly, because Sour was all about getting over heartbreak. And there's a time and a place to do that. And I feel like Sour was one of those albums that proved that. And I think that's why she executed her first album better than her second one, because it was solely heartbreak, whereas Guts is kind of a continuum of that. And people kind of get tired of that. But there were some songs on there that I really enjoyed. For example, I really liked Lacey, vocally speaking, Pretty Isn't Pretty, and Teenage Dream. Other than that, I don't have any other favorites because the rest are kind of the same old, unoriginal, similar key heartbreak song. If you don't agree with anything I say, I apologize. This is just the honest truth about how I feel about her. I hope you all have a great day. Take good care of yourselves, please and thank you. And I will see you in the next video.